brother.
God.
What's up?
This is a hey, good big party, man.
Yeah,
I
brother,
dig
like,
it.
Stop right up.
What's up? Hey, man, what's up?
Mother, there's too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Yeah. Father, Father, don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate.
You know we've got to find a way
to bring some loving here today. Oh, picket lines and picket signs. Punish me,
sister,
with brutality,
sister.
Talk to me,
sister,
so you can see,
sister.
Oh, what's going on?
What's going on?
What's going on?
No.
What's going on?
Y'all know what's going on? April 12, 2016, you are tuned into Heart to Heart Healthy Living with your host, Karen Khadijah Davis-Foulks. I want to thank you so much for tuning in, for joining, and sharing this radio broadcast with a friend. Yes, you are tuned into Heart to Heart Healthy Living. I'm so excited to be back live on the air of Inner Light Radio, and I'm sharing with you my journey. My journey to establishing my bioenergetic, bioinformational center. Oh, yes, and becoming a conscious self-healthcare educator and advisor. This is my real life radio show. It can be your real life radio show, too. You can call in and share your hero's journey to wellness. That's correct. That's what this show has been about, and that's what it will always be about. But the only difference is that I'm not just giving you information to help you along your wellness journey. I'm sharing my journey, my wellness stories. Last Tuesday, we started off with episode one of me sharing my journey to how I moved from disease care to conscious self-health care. So what's going on, community? What's going on with you and your health? How are you feeling? How are you really, really feeling? Tell the truth to yourself. That's what this month is all about. April, conscious self health care and lymphatic cellular wellness month. It's a month, it's opportunity for you to set back, take mental observation view. Look at how you have been caring for your health. How has your health progressed year after year, month after month? Remember, cells do rejuvenate themselves. You don't have to be in the same spot. This is an opportunity where you can evaluate what you've been doing, what you've been practicing, and how it has assisted you on your wellness journey. So thank you for tuning in. Thank you to our new listeners. I want to thank you all who joined our group this week. It was awesome to see people coming into the group wanting to share their information, because believe me, we're all in this together. So April is Conscious Self Healthcare Awareness Month, Lymphatic Cellular Wellness Month, because without all the systems in our bodies, the one system, well, the blood system, but the white blood system is a major blood system, the lymphatic system. That creates total wellness. It helps with the environment for the cells to live in. And so we want to become more educated about that system and not just think about our lymph nodes. Very, very crucial, but the whole system is. And so we celebrate this month the fact that we can take care of ourselves and we can bury the thought of disease care and disease thinking and just focus on wellness and maintaining this body. So this is opportunity on this show for you to take out pen and paper, physically or mentally, and write the information down that's going to assist you with making conscious self-healthcare moves. It's not just Conscious Self-Healthcare Awareness Month. It is also Poetry Month, celebrating 20 years. This is also Qigong Month, Chai Tea Month. It's time for us to take a breath. That's the prime pump for the lymphatic system, you know. That's why we feel so well when the fluids move through the body and the organs get an opportunity to relax. And then our state of mind relaxes. So all I would like for you to do now is, if you don't have your tea, you don't have what you need, take a moment, get what you need, sit back, relax, think about yourself, because we're all in this together. Simply team. They tell me team means together everyone achieves more. But how can I achieve more when you won't see me as I see you? How can I assist you when you do not see me as you and I do not see you as me? We are the divine beings of life source, not black, not white, not yellow, not brown, not green, or any other color. God is all, I am all, you are all, and we are all on this planet together. You see, they tell me team means together everyone achieves more. The challenge or vision for every person is to build a feeling of love, of oneness, and dependence on one another. Because the question is usually not how well each person lives independently, but how well we live together. That's part of the poem, Simply Team. Because as a team, we can unite and do so much for the good of the whole of humanity. And think in terms of the cells in your body. You put a single cell in a petri dish, and that cell thrives, does what it needs to do as long as that dish has the right environment. And if it doesn't, take it out of that environment and put that cell into a clean environment, the cell thrives. It comes back and rejuvenates itself and does its job. But that one cell knows what it was designed to do. It was designed to work as a whole. For in that one cell lives the whole entire universe that's inside of you. So when your cells work together because you consciously feed it the information for it to work together, the body performs better as a whole. Every single cell that created the body, the human body, every single cell we need. There is no need to remove any organs from your body. I don't believe they die when they say you have a disease. I believe that cell is in the wrong environment and you need to correct that environment, because we know that the cells rejuvenate themselves daily based on what you do. What is the raw materials that you are feeding to your body every day? Not only through food, through thought, through your environment, what you're doing, it creates a whole. So it can work independently, just like we can work independently. But it's so much more fun and it's so much better when you work together. That's why they say team means together everyone achieves more. So what are you doing? What is your part? What's going on in your life? Are you working as a team? Are you treating your body the way it needs to be treated? Are you doing the loving and kind things for your body to function like you want? Or are you sitting back hoping and wishing and praying? Are you feeling hopeless, that learned behavior? Or are you ready to just stand up, hug that disease so tight until it leaves your body, till it leaves your being? Embrace it. Don't run from it. We accept the fact that they say that we create diseases. But how are you living with that disease? Are you letting it take over your life? Or are you going to shift that energy, that thought, and create something new for yourself? That's what we're doing here. How did I reach this level of wellness, this level of understanding, because I believed and I understand and I believe it's true. Every single word that they have ever told me in the Western medicine understanding about how they care for the human body. I believe what they say. Why don't you believe what they say and do something different? Because the only true way for the body to heal, I am actually, honestly, 100% telling you, is to let go of the synthetic drugs, to let go of pharmaceuticals, and your body can begin to thrive. So how can I help you slay your fears? How can I assist you with moving forward? Because we are in this together. When we all move over to conscious self-health care, it becomes a better world. It becomes a better place to live. You will want to thrive more and not be concerned and live in that fear that they want you to live in. So, yes, you are tuned into Heart to Heart Healthy Living. I'm Karen Khadijah Davis-Foulks. They call me Dr. K from Washington, D.C., loving every minute of it. I'm here to share with you the information based on field therapy. We understand the physical body. It's time for us to understand more of the energetic body, how that body is designed, what is the field, and how the field is all connected. So when you take care of that physical body through the raw materials that it needs, it creates the environment for the lymphatic vessels to do their job. And when you breathe deeply, it supports the lymphatic system with moving the fluids through the body. That's why the breath is so important, because it pumps the lymphatic system. You know, the heart pumps the blood system. And when the lymphatic system becomes sluggish, that means that the blood becomes sluggish. That means that the heart gets in trouble. That means it spreads it through all other organs, and they become in trouble. So we have to sit back, take a deep breath, learn about lymphocyzing, and trust the power of the miraculous self-healing body. The field is the sole governing agent of the particle. And yes, you are the particle. There is order to your chaos. Conscious self-health care moves. Mental observation view is essential for your success. The reason I do not say viewed is because when you honor yourself as the sole governing agent of your physical being, your body, you know that chaos, challenges, gifts are your way of asking the question, am I working, living, thriving from a man-made mindset of human consciousness? That's my second question. Write it down. Ask yourself clearly. Am I working from a man-made mindset of human consciousness? Am I going through the intuitive feelings that I'm feeling? Am I not following that and following the thought of man telling me how I should think, how I should feel, what I should do? When I know that it's going against who I really am, the divine being that I am, I have given my power, my creation, to people, places, and things when I work from a man-made mindset of human consciousness. But you see, my consciousness is the sole governing agent of the particle, the human body. I am and you are the creator of your life. I am the creator of my life, and I choose to see it all in love and kindness. I have what I have, you have what you have in your life by right of consciousness. You can, and I can, and we all can, will anything to us. But we can only keep it by right of consciousness. So, diseases are error of thought. But if you keep that error of thought in mind, in your awareness, and you work from a man-made mindset of consciousness, then you must express it. You will feel it in your body. You will feel it in your being. You're telling every cell in your body to vibrate at a lower vibration. When you shift that energy and consciousness, when you understand that you are the sole governing agent of this particle, this human body. You see, humans, we create cellular malfunctions. Cells can malfunction. Cells can grow and regenerate themselves year after year, day after day, month after month, based on what you're thinking, what you're doing,
like
what you're saying, and
like
your environment.
CSI.
You can shift that at any time, and that's what they call miracles. You can shift at any moment. Shift your thinking, shift your action, shift your lifestyle, and you will feel change. But if it's not in your consciousness for real, you will only feel it for a moment. It will only be there for a little while. But if you hold on to that knowing thought of who you are and feel blessed by that thought, then you will create the life that you truly want. When you control your pathway to life, living in health, then you know you are the creator of your life. So you are tuned into Heart to Heart Healthy Living with Karen Khadijah Davis-Foulks, known as Dr. K, a native Washingtonian and founder of the Arc of Self-Healing and Self-Help. Health education for longevity and peace was established in 1997 as a health and wellness maintenance organization for the prevention of disease. It was a business. But now I know myself, and I know my mission, I know what I'm doing, and I know that this business has changed to a ministry. And I'm sharing this information to empower each and every person to take back control of their health. So when you listen to me on Tuesdays, you're listening to a message, a divine message from our ministry, from the Arc of Self-Healing and Self-Help. You now can say that for my gifts, I can get rewarded through healthcare, not just giving and not getting really anything in return. We want you to step up to assurance. You have insurance. This is where you get assurance. To not be afraid to let go of pharmaceuticals and disease thinking. And know with 100% that you have the power to shift the conditions of your body as soon as you decide that you want to. I have one goal, one purpose, one thought, one action, one vision, and one movement. One passion for sharing information, for empowering all, for rising above the fear of diseases. Yes, it's time to embrace that fear of diseases. It's time to give diseases a big old hug, hold it so tightly, just like you got a brand new gift. You know how you got that car out there you wanted? That fur coat you wanted, all that material stuff you wanted, and you love it so much. Love that thought that you think that's holding you back from getting up. Now, I know some of you are probably saying, I got a reward from being this way. So I want to be that way. And so we honor you. If you want to be that way, be that way. If that makes you feel good, you're getting what you want from the government, so you want to stay that way, then we honor that. I know I do. I want to work with the person that says, I thought they told me when I got this way that that was it. And if I did that, I would get better. But you see, you're not getting better. Day after day, month after month, year after year, you're feeling the same way. Oh, not the same way. Something else went wrong. And you're taking something else and you're doing something else. But when you're ready to leave that, to bury disease thinking, to step up out of the dark ages, this is the 21st century. They just didn't upgrade your cell phone. They just didn't upgrade your microwave. They just didn't upgrade all the material things. Is it time for man to upgrade his thinking? Is it time for man to upgrade his actions? Yes, you can upgrade yourself the same way that they have upgraded everything that we use in the world. So why do we want to sit back and stay in that same mindset and become a victim to our own self? We're not a victim to them. We are a victim to our own self. So are you ready? You. Don't turn around and look at nobody else. You. Are you ready to leave a man-made mindset of human consciousness about healthcare? Are you ready to relearn, rethink, and rewrite your personal healthcare prescription plan? That's what I'm here for. Help. The Arc of Self-Healing and Self-Help, Health Education for Longevity and Peace. It's some education out here, some information out here that you can actually use and step up. Now, you might not be in agreement with everyone around you because they're stuck in that old paradigm and they're too afraid to move forward. Don't let them hold you back. You didn't even got to argue with them. You don't even have to have a conversation with them. That's your physical body. You are the sole governing agent of that body. And you get to make a choice. You might go to that physician. You may go to that doctor. You may go to that practitioner. But you should be going there telling them that you know what is wrong with you. And you went to them because they can provide you with the system that you need to correct those cellular malfunctions. But if you go on to them asking them what's wrong with you and to fix you, this is the 21st century. It is not that difficult to understand basic cellular ecology, how to take care of your cells, your physical body, your energetic body, and the field that governs that body. It's not complicated, people. They wanted you to think that it was complicated, but it's not complicated at all. We are all at a choice point with our health care. And conscious self-health care techniques and advancement in quantum health information is leading the way with expanding your awareness and your self-responsibility for health care if you so choose. If you've been feeling a certain way, if you just knew in your heart, you feel that you want to do something different and you know you're going to hurt somebody else's feeling, maybe your daughter is a doctor. Maybe your husband is a doctor. Maybe your aunt, your uncle, your cousin, somebody's in the medical field, and you just don't want to hurt their feelings. You're not hurting their feelings. You are hurting your own feelings by not doing what you need to do for yourself based on somebody else's feelings. You have to honor yourself. And when you honor yourself first, you are honoring every other living person. So take a deep breath with me. And you just prime the pump for the lymphatic system to start your cellular wellness journey. I'm going to take a break, and I'm going to come back, and I'm going to continue to share my stories to wellness. Thank you for tuning in to Heart Healthy Living. And be sure to call a friend and tell them to tune in. Is it time for a new approach to your health care? Are you ready to lead the dark ages of disease care management and pharmaceuticals? If your answer is yes, get ready to relearn, rethink, and rewrite your personal health care prescription plan with Dr. K. She is a certified lymphologist and Nest healthcare provider, sharing the new science of information as medicine and cellular ecology. Did you know that the field of epigenetics states that you are more than just your genes, and those genes do not control your biology? Yes, that's correct. Schedule a Skype, phone, or office visit with Dr. K and get on board the friendship train to healthcare freedom. 202-248-7749. That's 202-248-7749. Visit us on the web, forcellife.com. The number 4, the words cell, cellife.com. That's right, gotta help one another. Cause they tell me team simply means together, everyone achieves more. So when we all step up to the truth and the understanding of how this physical body operates, when we all share the same principles that we understand to be the truth of life, not man, not from a man-made mindset of human consciousness, but that divine inner knowing that we know. You are tuned into Heart to Heart Healthy Living with Karen Khadijah Davis-Foulks, the one and only conscious self-healthcare educator. How can I help you slay your healthcare fears? Call in 310-928-7733 and you can share your wellness story. That's what this show is all about. You can also share your wellness story in our lymphatic wellness group, Lymphatic Wellness on Facebook, that group. You can also share your story on the group for the radio show. That is Heart to Heart Radio. That's a group. You can share your stories on the Emancipate Yourself from Medical Mental Slavery Day page, because April 30th is Emancipate Yourself from Medical Mental Slavery Day. That day you can honor yourself as we honor those individuals that share their wellness story on the website Conscious Self Healthcare. Conscious Self Healthcare. ConsciousSelfCare.com. 1S connects conscious and self. Click that appropriate link, share your stories, join us on our Facebook groups and our pages. Listen to the rebroadcast show on Wednesdays at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 8 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, and tell a friend to tune in. And yes, you heard this lady, she said, step up out of the dark ages of disease care. Yes, it's time to bury disease thinking. And why I am so adamant and strongly about how I choose to live my life that way, because I trust the Western medical system. They say they do not understand what they're doing. They're just doing something. They're following the pharmaceutical companies. You tell them you have something wrong. Their schooling told them to put it into a category, put it into these numbers and call it this, and tell them they have that and that these are your choices. Burn, cut, and drug. If you are finished with that lifestyle and you want to have a glorious, healthy life until your body decides it's time to let go of the coat and you're ready to move on, because yes, it is a choice. I've learned to trust them through my journey in Western medicine, so I don't even argue with them. I don't go to them trying to tell them something alternative, something natural, and thinking that they are going to believe it and follow me. They have one mind, one frame of thought, and one way to move when they're in that field, unless they decide to become responsible physicians and understand nutrition, understand consciousness, and understand the field that they're in. It's not the doctors, it's the field that they're in and how it's set up. But there are some doctors that choose to follow that rule of thought, disease care. And there are some doctors that know they just cannot do that anymore. They are shifting. The younger doctors are coming in and they can't take it. They know better. They have better information. And when they get into medical school and they hear all the stuff they have to go through that they know is no longer valid, they decided that they don't even want to practice that type of medicine anymore. It's time for us to wake up and make a change. And so I'm sharing my wellness journey and hope that you will continue to share your wellness journey with me through those particular means. This is something that I've never really done. I only share with people when you come to me for support. I don't really share my information, but I was told by the masters that everybody got a story, and that story is how they move forward and how they assist people by sharing a story. So I shared my fears with you. I've shared with you last week, and you can go back. You can go to my YouTube channel, K Davis, F as in Frank, and review episode 1. And you can join the group, Heart to Heart Radio, and you can listen to episode 1. I shared with you how I lived with fear all my life that I would die because they told me that it was hereditary. My father having kidney disease, a disease running in the family, him getting it young, and all I kept thinking was I was going to die. And so I even had a worrying pregnancy. I shared all that information to say that that is the state that I was in. I stopped when I was talking about 1992. So this is the biggest reason, community, family, and friends, why I do what I do, why I am so adamant. This is why I do what I do, because I understand what they have said to me through my experiences. So the year is 1992. I'm still working in corporate America, same job, doing great work, and I started the journey into managing stress at work. I did not want it to end up back in the hospital with any more ulcers. My husband and I decided that we would have a child. I didn't have any fears this time until my doctor told me, because of my history and my parents' history, that this would be a high-risk pregnancy and that I would have to stay off my feet and in the bed to have the baby. Now, by this time, I know too much information on natural healing and the process of life. And I said, no, I'm not staying in the bed for 9 months. I love my husband, but Karen was not going to do that. I felt I was going against nature. It was for the love of my sister that when she said, you never do what doctors say. You never do what doctors say do. Why won't you do this? That I was selfish. So I did it. I stayed in bed and only went to the hospital, the physician's office. And at about 2.5 months, I was told by the doctor that my child was coming. And they could stitch my vagina, and that would keep me from losing a baby. Now you know. I said, hell no. If this child wants to come after staying in bed all this time, then let it come. I'm not doing that. Now, this is a part of my why I really do what I do, promote conscious self-health care, what motivates me to shake up the status quo, to let people know that there is someone who understands why you do not follow the crowd when it comes to your health decisions, and have people trust in themselves and do what is best for them mentally, physically, emotionally, nutritionally, and spiritually, no matter who is asking them to do something different than what they believe or know in their heart, in their gut, to be true. Now, my husband, Alvin, fully invested in this pregnancy with me, asked me to please have the stitch done. And my mother joined in, repeating my sister's statement, her sentiments to me. And for the love of my husband and my mother, I did have the surgery. And with the fruit drugs, I felt better and believed that I could deliver this child alive and healthy. When you hear my first episode, you will know that my first child broke away from my body and she was stillborn. But I believed in what they believed in, and I had the surgery. Well, let me tell you, I was rushed to the hospital at 25 weeks, and I delivered a baby boy weighing 1 pound, 5 ounces. He looked weak and limp to me, but I've never said that word in my life before, limp. But I say he looked so weak and limp to me, and believe it or not, I said he almost looked dead. And the doctor said he had a strong, healthy heart. And I'm like, he has a strong, healthy heart? And you've been telling me all my life I got a weak heart, a strange heart. But he has a strong, healthy heart, and he's limp and he's weak. But I kept thinking how lifeless and limp he looked. My son will be named Kavanaugh Russell Foulks. Kavanaugh would stay in the hospital for nearly 5 months. My son transitioned 2 hours after being released. They told me the whole time that he was getting better, that he was thriving, looking good, fatten him up, cheeks all rosy, eyes all bright. My spirit and intuition were telling me something different. No matter how healthy he looked, he was on wet oxygen the whole time in the hospital. Didn't know that had a different meaning. And when they sent him home, he was on dry oxygen. and scheduled for surgery at another hospital. Couldn't understand that. I fought like hell to keep him in the hospital. Why are you going to release my child to me to take him to another hospital for surgery? Couldn't understand that to save my life, but I protest. I could not understand why Kavanaugh had to go to another hospital for a hernia surgery. Oh, I surely didn't. I soon knew he was dying the whole time. And the medicine and the wet oxygen kept him appearing to look alive and well. You know, when they released him from the hospital, that second hospital refused to admit him, telling my husband and me to bring him back that Monday morning. Woo, Lord, my heart and spirit were broken. I knew better that I should not have followed my, I knew that I should have followed my feelings in the beginning. But no, I listened to other people. And in a sense, I'm happy that I did. So much came out. And it was out of my search to find out the truth of why I had this experience that I found healing and the International Academy of Lymphology. I learned the seven major discoveries in medicine, the process of the life of a cell at the cellular level. How well we care for the cells is how well our body will be. I received my certification as a lymphologist, and I created the Arc of Self-Healing and Self-Help, Health Education for Longevity and Peace, a health and wellness maintenance organization for the prevention of disease, to share the science of lymphology, the new science, the art of lymphocyzing, and mainly that we do not create conditions named diseases. We create cellular malfunctions. To all people that have an ear to hear, the heart to understand, and the mind to believe in the power of the miraculous self-healing body, the main reason I wake up every day to share this information to assist all individuals to know that it is time to step up out of the dark ages of disease care, because that's what it is, disease care. It is not wellness. It's disease care. They call your cellular malfunction diseases. They pretend that the medication is going to make you all better and well when they know that it's a chemical drug that tears the body down. My son spent 5 months in that hospital. He went from limp, barely alive, no movement, to looking fat and healthy, and died 2 hours after he was released. Nobody on this earth can tell me that they did not know that my son was going to die when they released him from that hospital. I know they knew it, because by the time I got home and he died, the doctor was in my door not 10 minutes later. So I know they knew it. They know what they're doing. Yes, they can predict when you're going to die, not the exact moment, but they know that their medication is keeping you alive in a state that is unhealthy. And when your body takes over, if it's not strong enough, if it's not thriving enough, it will do exactly what you have in it to do, break down. Take a deep breath with me. The signs of lymphology moves lymphatic vessels. That's the only thing that moves the lymphatic vessels is vertical movement. Exercising don't move lymphatics. Walking without a movement with it don't move lymphatics. Every time you breathe, you're moving your lymphatic system. You're helping it to get rid of. You're helping it to purify the environment. My son was born to give me a lesson. I had no idea that I would become a lymphologist. I had no idea that I would understand cells and cellular ecology. And stick with that, because that is the truth. It's not rocket science to understand how the body works. It's rocket science to understand how to get a rocket up into the atmosphere. But cellular ecology, Dr. Samuel C. West said an 8-year-old can learn it. So let's stick with the basics. So I invite you to join my group, Lymphatic Wellness on Facebook. Let's move together. Let's do this together. Let's step up out of the dark ages of disease care together. There is nothing inside of me that would ever shift my energy from knowing that we create cellular malfunctions. I fully, fully understand. Yes, I do. And you can too. You can let go of your fears that is hereditary, that your cells break down and an organ must be removed, that it cannot rejuvenate itself. Change the environment, you change the life of the cell. The raw materials that you give your body will determine how well your cells work. Because we know we can live on junk food. We know that we can live on pharmaceuticals. But how well are you living? What is your level of wellness every day, daily? What are you thinking? Take a deep breath. It's okay. Relearn, rethink, rewrite your very own prescription plan. You are in control. No one else is in control. You are in control. That's part of the reasons why I do what I do, because of my experience. The same way I heard them tell me when I went to have the fibroids removed, she created that. That's her body we taking out. You not cutting out my body. I'm out of here. She's got bleeding ulcers now. What is an ulcer? Oh, I thought it was something that came in my stomach. No, that is my stomach? Oh, hell no. We ain't cutting that out. We getting up out of here. We got to make some conscious decisions to change. And it's not difficult. It's not hard to do when you tune into yourself. It's not hard to do. Tune into yourself. It's not about having 1580 AM or Magic 102.3 FM. It's about tuning into yourself. Remove yourself. Get out of the way. Stop the static. Release your energy. Tune into yourself. Challenge yourself, your greater self, to tune into Heaven 101. Just stop. Be still. The power is within. Tune into yourself. I listen to rock, pop, jazz, and blues. I know the words and some lyrics too. But have I listened to self? That inner wealth? That invisible soul of my soul? You got to thank the power that be. You're always safe when you tune into yourself. Never any uncertainties. The frequencies are always clear. Tune into Heaven 101. Channel and control. Tune into yourself. You are eternal, infinite, and whole. Believe me, you will go on forever. From expression to expressions. From experiences to experiences. But you got to tune into yourself. When you want to feel the beat, when you want to know the lyrics, you tune into the artist. To receive the right vibes, you're doing it to Donnie Simpson in the morning, Les Brown in the morning, Tom Joyner in the morning, whoever in the evening, and whoever during the lunchtime cafe, family, community, and friends, I tell you, it's time to tune into yourself. When you want the truth, when you want to hear the truth, tune into your conscious mind. Heaven 101, tune into yourself. You see, you got to thank the power that be. Oh, I want you to tune into Heart to Heart Healthy Living. Oh, yes, I do. I want you to tune into all the other shows on Inner Light Radio. And when you tune in and you get that information, it's time to sit down, pull out that pen and paper. Look at your conscious thinking. Become aware of how you're thinking. It's time to relearn, rethink, and rewrite. Learned behavior will keep you in that state of fear. Let go of learned behavior. It's time for you to teach yourself. That's what I'm doing. Together we can achieve more. But when you take responsibility as the sole governing agent of your particle body, it benefits us all. Take a station break. Come back. You can tune in. Call in. 310-928-7733. 310-928-7733. I got my Facebook page open and I see people joining my group. Thank you very much. Liking my post of today. Thank you very much. I appreciate you tagging in and going on. And Jermaine, before we take the break, Jermaine via Facebook, you talk about the healing powers of coconut water and the meat of a coconut. What is there to say? You just said it. The healing powers of coconut and coconut water. And how coconut, eating it every day, changes the environment of the body. See, the thing about it, family, community, and friends, earth, mother, seed, nourishment. Dense nutrition is what corrects cellular malfunctions. When your cells malfunction, they do not have a deficiency for drugs, pharmaceuticals, over-the-counter medication. Cells survive off of the raw materials from the seed of the earth. So it is true. You need dense nutrition. We used to get that from the foods that we ate before man decided to create food out of chemicals. So yes, for the physical body, for it to perform and operate at its best, you have to give it dense nutrition. Coconut water. Your body is to be alkaline and your body is to be acidity. Your body is a miraculous self-healing device. It knows what to do to self-correct. From my point of view, when a person is having challenges with cellular malfunctions, let's look at what you're putting in the body for the physical body. But you have to remember, every cell has a field. The field is how the cells communicate. You create energy, but the cells communicate through information. So that's the field. The information is coming from you. You are the sole governing agent of the particle. The particle is below. Remember, healing takes place. Step down. Consciousness into the body. So not only do you need to take care of the physical body, get that environment right, feed the cells what they need, not chemical food created by man. And we have to be so careful now because we know of the seeds of Masato. We got more people eating fruits and vegetables, but they're eating it with no seeds. They're happy. Well, my watermelon ain't had no seed in it. Come on, people. That's not watermelon. That's man-made. It got to have a seed in it. Dense nutrition is how you correct cellular malfunctions. So that's what we want to do. We want to work with nature. All the healing arts work. That's true integration. Integration, for me, is using all the healing arts, using the seed of the earth through plants, through the garden. These are the things that we need for the physical body. And it can self-correct itself at any time. But if you don't have it in mind, if you don't have it in right of consciousness, you will not keep it. It would definitely leave you. So we're all in this together. Because team, everybody achieves more when we work together. So that's what this show is all about. That's why I'm sharing my personal journey, my stories to wellness. And I want to hear your story to wellness. I want to hear how you self-correct something. I want to hear how you stepped up out of the dark ages into control of your health. Don't care what nobody else asks you to do. Oh, please have that surgery. I don't want you to die. We are all going to leave this planet Earth. We are all going to, as they say, die, transition. This physical body will lay down. But do you want to walk around Earth worried about a disease? You want to keep saying, I got a disease. It got me. My doctor said. If you're ready to shift that energy, believe me, billions of people on planet Earth are helping you shift that energy. We are here to work together as one. I'm a bioenergetic, bioinformational wellness specialist. I want to help you understand that you can correct all cellular malfunctions. They're not diseases, only to the Western system. So I don't want to be a part of that. That's not integration. I'm not going to send you back to them when you come to me. We're going to work together. We're going to find a way to help you shift your energy. Understand that it's all about you and how you take care of this body. You are the sole governing agent of the particle. 100 years ago, and it's been proven to this day that that information is true. Embrace it. Love it. Honor it. I'm so thankful that you're tuning into Heart to Heart. I'm so thankful that I can share this information with you. You know, remember, visit my YouTube channel, K Davis F. Like our pages on Facebook, Emancipate Yourself from Medical Mental Slavery Day, Eradicate Disease Thinking, Heart to Heart, Healthy Living. Join our group, Lymphatic Wellness. That's a new group. We're talking about understanding the power of the lymphatic system. That's where your known information comes from when they say you have cancer. That's because you have a weak immune system, your lymphatic system. God and angel of the body. We got to move that stuff around. It can't stay stagnated. Lymph got to move, purify the body. Your lymphatic vessel need to do its job. You know we got more lymphatic vessels in the body than blood vessels. Cleanup is more important. The body got to be able to clean itself up. We want to nourish our bodies. It's important. Dead food don't nourish the body. Living foods nourish the body. You got to create the right balance. Homeostasis and allostasis. The body got to be at a certain temperature. The water levels got to be a certain way, homeostasis. Allostasis, the body self-correct. It is adaptive. It will adapt itself. You put them drugs in your body, it's going to adapt itself. It's going to try to get rid of it while it's trying to repair you. It's not understanding, it's confused. It feels the frequency of the nature of a plant, but it's chemical-based, so it's not true. And the body knows it, and it's struggling. We don't have to struggle, family, community, and friends. We can thrive until we are ready to make our transitions. So are you ready to join the self-care movement? We're going to have a ball Saturday, April 30th, right here on Inner Light Radio as we honor those individuals that stepped up out of the dark ages of disease care. We got a panel of about 8 wonderful, renowned people that's going to be sharing with you how they're helping the movement. We have doctors. We have people from all walks of life sharing how they shifted their energies from a man-made mindset of human consciousness about health care. Yes, it's time to tune into yourself. When you get that information, process it for yourself. Reach your agreements for yourself. Have it in right of your consciousness for yourself. And don't let any smooth talker come along and change you from it until you need to take this and that and depend on that. Because the number one thing that supports cell life is your consciousness, your awareness, what you are thinking, what you know. Believe you can, believe you can't. You are right. So get to knowing who you are. You say you are a divine being, then start acting like you are a divine being. You are tuned into Heart to Heart Healthy Living. Karen Khadijah Davis, folks. We're having a ball each and every day. Are you ready? I'm going to share with you a post that I got today. This week, I put this post out. It says, it was a post that I put out by Dr. Sabi, because we all know that he won his case in New York against the American Medical Association in court, tried to take him to court, saying that he was falsely saying that he was curing diseases, because we know there are no diseases. We have cellular malfunction. So with his good food, his good nutrition, the cells began to work differently. So their tests, when they went back, changed. They didn't have these so-called diseases anymore. So I put the post out with his information, and I said, you are so right, Dr. Sabi. We create cellular malfunctions, not diseases. April is Conscious Self Healthcare and Lymphatic Cellular Wellness Month. April 30th is Emancipate Yourself from Medical Mental Slavery Day. Come on, practitioners, help me join in, spread the word about this month. Join us for the 6th Annual Conscious Self-Care Awards Program and the 2nd Global Conscious Self-Healthcare Panel Radio Show right here on Inner Light Radio, Saturday, April the 30th, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Share with a friend. We would love to share your hero story to wellness right here on Heart to Heart Healthy Living. Every Tuesday, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, and 5 p.m. Central Standard Time. One of my Facebook friends says, my body and soul have been pushing me to eat less to get ready for a fast soon. After 12 years of undiagnosed chronic Lyme, I'm tired. The antibiotics hurt and barely work. This is what I said. Thank you for sharing. Love is all there is, and sounds like to me you are ready to listen to your body and soul. I ask her to join the group Lymphatic Wellness. Maybe the information will assist you on your wellness journey. And if you feel that I can help you slay your healthcare fears, contact me. 202-248-7749. Skype Mindfulness for Health. Mindful for a numeral for health. Facebook Karen Davis Foulks. We are all in this together, and we can move beyond. And when you're thinking about fasting, sometimes you can just start off by giving yourself dense nutrition. Sometimes when you start off on a fast, it's hard on the body. Your body's been struggling, and then you want to make it struggle even more. And then it gets confusing. You know, your liver may not be as clean as it need to be. Then it dumps into the kidney. Kidney not maybe red. The colon might be compacted, and it all just circulates, and the blood just gets dirty and dirty. So sometimes you might just need to start giving yourself good nutrition. Just don't fast, just change the diet, add in more live food, add in good nutrition, and the body does what? Purifies and cleanses itself. Because that's what you go through. The body has to purify and cleanse itself. So why not build it up and let it be the master control of how it needs to do that? You don't have to force anything. And then when you start feeling better, then you can cut back less. And then you can do the fast with ease. Thank you so much for tuning in. So excited to share this information with you. I'm not shifting my energy. We create cellular malfunctions. You have someone that's been in bed, they've been sick for a while. You can shift their energy. You can talk to them. You can get them off the medication, and they just may get up and start walking and say thank you. Don't be afraid to step up out of the dark ages of disease care. No doctor that works in the medical field of disease care is going to release you. What I say? You cannot go to a doctor and tell them that you're doing something alternative. They're not going to release you. That's their job. That's their bread and butter, to keep you company to them every 3 months. So take a deep breath. Tune in next Tuesday to Heart Healthy Living. Contact me on Facebook. Let's do this together. Because together, everyone achieves more.
Said your mind is ready.
Ride on. Ride on the friendship train.
You know, we can think of no
ride on
better place.
Thank you for listening to Heart to Heart Healthy Living. Wow. We had a great time. And thank you for joining us and sharing this radio show with a friend. Now tune back next week, Tuesday, from 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 5 p.m. Central Standard Time. We invite you to visit ConsciousSelfCare.com, ConsciousSelfCare.com, and join the Conscious Self Healthcare Movement. Health is consciousness, and healing is a function of consciousness. You have a God-given right to choose your pathway to healthcare and wellness. I'm Karen Khadija Davis-Foulks, and tune in next Tuesday, Heart to Heart. Everybody get on.